What a fantastic day to make a video. The sun is shining, the birds are singing, we are locked down, so I don't have to meet people. And today I get to review Kloppmann pickups, which is one of my absolute favorite topics in the world, so let's get this started. First, let me mention that you just heard the raw sound of this bass. It's just plugged straight into the recording system, so no plugins, no EQ, no compression, no post-processing whatsoever. Hi, my name is Gregor. Our bass player for today is René Flexenhaar, and here we have today's Kloppmann pickups in review. Andreas Kloppmann, the king of the north when it comes to pickup production here in Germany, is a crazy guy. He collects pickups, but not really the pickups, much more the data that he gathers when he's repairing pickups for other guys. And just he collects all of this information, puts it in a huge database, and with this he's able to recreate all of those amazing vintage pickups. We will talk about the single coil set in my Sandberg in a moment, but first let's discover his 63 P-Bass pickup, which is currently in my Antigua Fender P-Bass. I don't have it before and after recording, which I agree would have been a top-notch thing this video, but that's just not how we roll. But let me just tell you, this is an okay bass. Not too good, not too bad, just somewhere in the middle. Just an average bass. However, with the Kloppmann pickup, what a great bass suddenly. And now let's hear it again with a pick. I'm not a pickup guru, so I have no idea what makes Kloppmann pickups actually so different from others. All I know is that these pickups are able to just bring dead instruments to life. In the meantime, the pickup is moved. Sorry, I pretended for a moment that those are Kloppmann pickups. Of course, you heard Kloppmann pickups, but they are just not in here anymore. They are now in my Fender Mexican Player Series P-Bass, and man, and woman, and diverse. It's just so good. Those are in here to stay. I don't have any recordings yet, but this bass is pretty much in every video at the moment, so you will get to hear it sooner or later. And unfortunately, I can't play it myself. No hands. But now let's grab the bass you have probably been waiting for. 2 weeks ago, we reviewed this Fender American Professional 2 Jazz Bass, which is a fantastic instrument, but it has a little flaw. Not really a flaw, but the pickups can just be improved. And with Kloppmann pickups, this bass, wow. More bass, more mids, but they're not just louder, they just emphasize the right stuff. I've put these pickups in tons of basses, in Fender custom shops as well as Squire Affinity, like just the cheapest jazz basses, and they actually were always an amazing improvement, so it's worth it. And I also created entire limited bass series around these pickups because I love them so much. And actually this Sandberg here is a result of all those Kloppmann-related activities of my younger, slimmer self back in the days. I don't know how to make myself clear, so let me just say it like this, and this might be a little bit controversial and might be the cause that I never get to review any other jazz bass pickups again, but I don't care, I have Kloppmanns. Let me say it, I believe these are the best jazz bass pickups you can buy for money. If you talk about real authentic jazz bass sounds, of course there's tons of other great sets out there, I don't want to neglect them. I really love, for example, the hum cancelling ones from Lindy Frehlin or Aguilar's and Nordstrand, all great manufacturers, no doubt. But if you ever played an old, all original jazz bass, I think this is the closest you will get your new existing bass in this direction. For those who already are familiar with Kloppmann pickups and just watched this video to get their beliefs reconfirmed by a bald guy with an Eastern German accent, Here's something new. Andreas Kloppmann told me recently about a new jazz bass set he has developed. It has something to do with lacquer in or on the pickup. I don't know. I don't understand any of this. But whenever there's a sentence with new Kloppmann and jazz bass in one sentence, just count me in, whatever it is. After some beta testing, the preferred mixture actually seems to be the new lacquered whatever bridge pickup in combination with the old traditional neck pickup that I also have in my Sandberg bass. So that's what we got here. And so new bridge pickup, show me what you got. I'm a neck pickup guy, it even says it on my passport, but I have to agree this was just very, very lovely. And once we are at this point, of course, we also need to talk about prices a little bit, because I guess you have already guessed it. These pickups are expensive as f***. This P-Bass pickup costs substantially more than this entire bass here, which also sounds actually incredibly good, and I'm mentioning this just to trigger some gear snobs. Yeah, but that's how the world goes. If you want to have the best of the best, you got to pay top dollar. That's just how it is. And yeah, I guess that's all I can say today. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time. Bye.